it's one of the less flamboyant brands out there when you go, at least in the UK, but I really think it's a brand which should not be overlooked. So I'm going to talk about the things which I've got from the brand and just encourage you to have a look at it. Recently I was able to attend a Trish McEvoy masterclass, and she does these quite regularly, especially I think she does them in America, does them in England. She's very active in teaching, and it's one of the major points of the brand to spread the word and let women understand how to improve themselves through makeup. And unfortunately Trish McEvoy was scheduled to attend, but she had filming commitments. But I still managed to email her with some questions, and I'm really delighted to say that she's taken the time to answer the questions, and it makes some really interesting reading. Trish McEvoy is not only the face of the brand, but she's really active in what goes in the products, how the products are designed, the brushes, and she has books and she does these masterclasses. And it's just really refreshing in this day and age when brands are very much owned by umbrella companies, and you start to see makeup mirroring other brands' makeup, and you start thinking, hang on, that packaging is exactly like that packaging, but that's cheap and that's expensive. So, you know, with Trish McEvoy there's none of that. All the products are really unique, really individual, and really high quality. So anyhow, the first thing I'd like to say is a very dear friend of mine gave me this planner as a present. It was so, so generous. I'll never forget that. This is of course one of Trish McEvoy's famous planners. Real leather, it's beautiful. This one's Tiffany blue. You can get various colours, and she also brings out smaller ones and seasonal ones, and some of them are very modern, like leopard print, but most of them are classic. This is like buying a really lovely handbag, because it is a few hundred pounds, so it's not a throwaway purchase. But the thing with this is that it's really well made, and if I wanted to, I could leave this on my deathbed for another generation to enjoy. And inside you get this section for brushes, and this is big enough to hold full-size brushes. And I've just put some of my products in there, so I'm going to talk about it. So one side has got a pouch which opens up, and the other side has got brush space. And as you can see, it's got this binder, much like a folder, where you put your planner pages in. Now this is the old style planner page. She's brought out new ones which has got half black here, I think. And I've just put a few products in here. This is a definer, and this is the blue one. I think it's called Arabian Nights. This is a very lovely neutral shade. This is a blusher, that's another blusher. I really love Trish McEvoy eyeshadows. I think they apply really smoothly, really pigmented. You don't have to put your brush in there lots of times, just touch it. You get enough colour, really smooth, soft. And they come in these plastic boxes like this. And then you have to purchase a planner page or some other magnetic holder, and you put them in and they sort of fit like Tetris. So very eco-friendly, but on the other hand a bit less convenient, because you do have to buy the planner pages. So that's that. Then I've just brought some brushes to show you. This is the number 37 bronzer brush. I love this, really smooth, amazing for loose powder coverage, or of course bronzer, really beautiful. I think it's Blue Squirrel Hair. It's a lot softer than MAC or basically any brand, and she designs them all herself. And I asked her about how she designs her brushes, and it was really interesting hearing how she goes about it. So do you have a read? So that's number 37. This is a discontinued brush, but I love it because this is number 14, and I think it was designed as a highlighting brush. But I've got quite big features, so I use it to shade down my nose, and it works amazingly for that. So I just put my sculpting powder on and just shadow in the sides of my nose to make it look thinner. It's brilliant for that. It's also really good for a soft wash of colour for your eyes. Use it for that as well. And then there's this brush, and this is the best brush ever for pigments. It's the number 21 large laydown brush. Packing on your pigment, just one touch, it's got a nice big head, and also it's made out of fibres which you can use for cream or shadow. You can even use this for concealer as well. Another product which I really love is this essential pencil, and this one is in Barely There. It's a really good natural lip colour, and I really like the way it applies very smoothly, just like a lipstick, and it lasts really well. So this is the product which I use when I have those no makeup days. This is Trish McEvoy Eye Base Essentials, and this one is in Demure. And literally, this eye base has become my favourite eye base. It's a bit more expensive than Urban Decay Primer Potion, but it lasts just as well as Primer Potion. It also conceals any imperfections. It gives a brilliant brightening effect to the eye. It's even got very tiny imperceptible glitters which make your skin look awake and also provide a lovely slight shimmer to your eyeshadows. I absolutely adore this product and really, really highly recommend it. Another fantastic product, and this is my backup, is Trish McEvoy Finish Line Shadow Transformer. This makes any shadow into a brilliant dark liner which lasts through anything. Comes in this tiny pipette bottle, which I really love, very scientific looking, and it works with any shadows, especially the Trish McEvoy Shadow Definers. I also use this with MAC glitters, and it really makes them show up brilliantly. Just leaves my other latest purchase, which is the Trish McEvoy Beauty Emergency Card, which I haven't really used much yet because I'm trying to save it for travel, but I have used it. It's so slim, I just adore how slim it is. It's a good way to try the brand, and you get that beautiful aubergine definer, you get all these wonderful neutral colours, and you can actually create a sort of taupey smoky eye, or a purple smoky eye, or a very neutral nude eye. It's actually surprisingly versatile. So I love this and really highly recommend that as well. Once again, please check the link below and you'll hear from the woman herself. So thank you very much to Trish McEvoy for doing that, of course. And I hope it gives you an insight into the brand. I'll talk to you all soon. All the best. Bye.